In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, God's good people, and welcome. Today is Friday, the 21st of May, 2021. It is Friday of the 7th week of Easter, Church Year B. You are listening to Catholic Meditation, broadcasting over Radio Evangelium of the Diocese of Kumba. I am your servant, Father Blessed Ambang Njume. Thanks for always being a part of us. Let us pray. O God, who by the glorification of your Christ and the light of the Holy Spirit have unlocked for us the gates of eternity, grant, we pray, that partaking of so great a gift, our devotion may grow deeper and our faith be strengthened. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is taken from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 25, verses 13 to 21. The responsorial psalm is taken from Psalm 103. The response to the psalm is, "The Lord has fixed his throne in heaven." The gospel is taken from St. John, chapter 21, verses 15 to 19. I read from the gospel. When they had eaten, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these others do?" He answered, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." A second time he said to him, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" He replied, "Yes, Lord, you know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Look after my sheep." Then he said to him a third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter was hurt that he asked him a third time, "Do you love me?" and said, "Lord, you know everything. You know I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep. In all truth, I tell you, when you were young, you put on your own belt and walked where you liked. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands and somebody else will put a belt around you and take you where you would rather not go." In these words, he indicated the kind of death by which Peter would give glory to God. After this, he said, "Follow me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. The theme for today's meditation is Let your past not scare you. Jesus is concerned about how much you love him. Let your past not scare you. Jesus is concerned about how much you love him. Dear friends in Christ, today's gospel episode is situated within the context of the post-resurrection appearances. The whole drama of the betrayal of Jesus by Judas, the triple denial by Peter of not knowing Jesus, Jesus' torture, crucifixion, and death all having been over, he resurrected as he said he would and as he had promised. In this episode recorded by today's gospel passage, he appeared to the apostles but addressed himself particularly to Peter. Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these others do? Jesus asked him. It was a question that touched Peter to the heart. It also kept him worried. The incident of denying thrice not knowing his master was still very fresh. Though he wept after the event, it was a scar that kept reminding him of the mess he had done. Oh, just how Peter wished something like that had never happened. But here he was. The deed had already been done. Now, here was Jesus asking him if he loved him. Peter surely thought Jesus still had the incident in mind. Was Jesus still having the denial in his mind? Was he coming now for a revenge? I can imagine Peter's thoughts when Jesus asked that question. And not only once. Jesus asked him 3 times. Peter, do you love me? Peter supposed Jesus was still mad at him. What was the reason for asking? Why the insistence? 3 times he denied not knowing Jesus, and 3 times Jesus asked if he loved him, and in all 3 times Peter responded, "Yes, Lord, I love you." As it were, each response canceling the 3 previous denials he had uttered. The final and 3rd time, Peter answered in a more profound way, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." Peter appealed to Jesus' omniscience. Beloved of God, these are very deep words. Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you. By this, Peter meant, Lord, you can read everyone's heart and mind. You know everything. Yes, I know I denied you, but deep in my heart, I love you, and I know you know I love you. And Jesus said to him, feed my sheep. Look after my lambs. Now the question is, why did Jesus entrust this task to Peter, even after he had denied him 3? The other apostles were there. There was Jude. There was Simon. There was Bartholomew. Or the lovely John, who did not deny him. Why did Jesus not entrust them the task? Why Peter, the Peter who had denied him? Oh, beloved of God, God knows us. Human beings will easily push us away because of our weaknesses. For God, he sees beyond our human weakness. The answer that Jesus gave Peter brings out the lesson of today's meditation and from the gospel passage. Feed my sheep. Look after my lambs. God reads and knows our hearts and intentions, and he is not carried away or worried by our human mistakes. He knew the strength of Peter, a strength the others did not have, even if they had not denied him. He knew what Peter could do that the others could not, despite his own limitations. All God needs from us is a commitment and a readiness to bounce back when we fall. All he needs from us is our assurance that we love him. The problem is in not falling, but rising when we fall and making the determination to move forward and to be better. It is about how much we love God. And if you love God, even when you fall like a Peter, you weep, you bounce back, and you return to God and prove to him just how much you love him. So too God is asking you, do you love me? He knows of your weaknesses, but do you love him? This is what the priest says always at every Holy Mass when he utters the words, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. By this is meant, God should not look at us in our human weakness and brokenness, but should look at the faith of the church. Likewise with you, dear friend, God is not concerned about your human brokenness. He is not concerned about your filth. Rather, he is concerned about how much love you have for him. Because if you do love him, you will have remorse for the wrong that you do. If you love him, you will be sorry for the evil you do and you will bounce back. But if you do not love him, you will not even have remorse for the evil you have done. So he asks you, as he asked Peter, do you love me? Lord, we may be weak. We may be broken. Oh dear Lord, we are all messed up by our weaknesses and brokenness. But oh dear Lord, despite all that, we love you. Smile over our mistakes and look at the love we have for you, though it might be imperfect. We may deny knowing you like Peter, and sometimes even many more times than he did. But oh dear Lord, you know everything. You know that deep inside of us, we love you and we want to come to heaven. Dear friend, do not be discouraged. Let your brokenness not scare you. God knows. Let your weaknesses not discourage you. God understands. Yet, he still wants to use you like he used Peter. All he needs from you is an assurance of love. God will never use your dirty past against you. He will not haunt you for the errors of yesterday, only if you truly love him and are ready to change and be better. Again, he asks you, do you love him? Peter said, yes, Lord, I love you. And he changed from his past and proved his love by following Jesus and denying any other thing that was contrary. In fact, he died out of love for Jesus and for the gospel. Jesus did not say to Peter, Peter, here we are, you see? You denied me, and now I am back. Yeah, I am. You see your life? If it were some of us in Jesus' shoes, we would have promised Peter hell. But no, our God is a God who forgets the past. I tell you, he has forgotten your own past. All he needs from you is for you to assure him that you love him and be determined to be better. Let your own past not scare you. Even after you would have done all the wrongs you have done in the past, Jesus looks at you deep into your eyes. He calls you by name and he asks of you, do you love me? All what we need to do now is to become another Peter. Prove your love for Jesus, that your mistake in the past was but for human weakness. He wants to use you. He needs you despite your human weakness, despite your brokenness. There is much that you can do for him and that only you can do. And that is why, despite your brokenness, he still comes to you. Just tell him like Peter did, Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you, even in my weakness, even in my brokenness. And when you say that, prove the love that you have by bouncing back to become a better you as Peter did. God bless you. And do not give up, dear friend. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever. Amen. Catholic meditation with me, Father Blessed.